and her mind immediately moved upon torments that she might inflict.
Oria?
Yes?
There is a place far off, Sophia. Nothing grows there. No wheat, no grass, no trees. There you'll find huddling together cold, fear, and gaunt hunger. Tell hunger I command her to visit this brute and establish a home for herself in his belly. I give him to her as a toy.
I will.
I would go myself, but it's forbidden for hunger me ever to meet.
Orianne flew off to Caucasus, a bleak and nightmarish region. There, in a field of stones, crouched hunger, pulling from between the rocks with her teeth and filthy fingernails, some tiny bits of moss. Her hair hung down in lank and matted locks. Her eyes were sunken and circled. Her lips were slack and cracked. The vaults of her ribs stuck out, as did every bone in her body. One could count the knobs of her spine.
Hunger? Ceres commands you. Or rather, permits you.
Yes.
To go to Erisichthon and to never leave him until he is finished.
Glad.
Hunger crawled through the air to the house of the victim. As she flew overhead, fields withered and men starved. Birds scattered from her path, too weak to fly. It is night when she arrives at Erisichthon's home and curdles through the hall until she finds him sleeping in his room. She wraps cadaverous arms around him in an embrace as strong as love, but quite the opposite of love. She breathes her spirit into his spirit, and he begins to dream. Pastries. Cheese. Grapes. He wakes.
Bring me something to eat, anything. I'm starving.
But he can't wait to be served. He begins to eat everything around him, meal after meal after meal after meal. But he can't shake this hunger.
I need more, more to eat.
Baked shrimp and mushrooms, salami and ice cream, liver and donuts, everything in every possible combination. Even as he eats, he is planning other menus and complaining of his hunger. As the ocean ingests the waters from the rivers of the world, yet still remains thirsty and guzzles more and more forever, so he calls out for more.
It isn't enough! It isn't enough.
His hunger empties the larder and warehouses, the storerooms and barns of the city. His hunger is unabated. What is left to sell?
Mother!
Son!
Come with me.
Now, this part is true, though you may not believe it. His hunger led him to sell his poor, his darling mother.
She doesn't look so strong.
She is! She is! We've had her forever!
I can't pay you much.
Just give it to me.
With the few coins he received, Erisichthon ran home to eat. Riding in a boat behind her new master, Erisichthon's mother leaned over the hull and prayed to someone she once knew.
Oh, Poseidon, if you remember me, come and save me now!
From the briny deep, Poseidon heard her prayer, pulled her into the water, and changed her back into the little girl who used to play along the shores. salty water licked the years away until she emerged, the one who gave him praise in childhood, shouting as she ran among the waves. This is the kind of sweet, unbidden praise the gods adore and do not forget.
Listen up. Where is the old woman that was here a moment ago? Did she dive overboard and swim up the shore?
Sir, I swear by the down of the sea that no one except myself has come to the shore. I swear it.
To this day, at every hour, somewhere in the world, you can still catch a glimpse of that little child playing by the shore. But let us return to our king. It was not enough. The money she had earned for him was not enough to fulfill his needs. The emptiness within him was unappeasable. You've met such men yourself, I'm sure.
I need more. I must have more.
The godless are always hungry.
More!
Always yelling at waitresses.
I want more.
There can be only one end to such a man. He will destroy himself.
Bon appétit!